online class. My dear students, in the last class, we were discussing about a poem, No Men Are Foreign, written by James Kirkup, which gives a beautiful message of what? Yes, universal brotherhood. Universal brotherhood in a sense, whole world is my family. It means we have to treat not only our neighbors, not only our relations, not only our brother and sisters, not only the people of a country as a brothers, but the people of the entire globe, the people of the entire world is just like my family, or is just like our family. That is the message which the James Kirkup wants to give to the reader by the help of the poem No Men Are Foreign. So in the last class we discussed the two stanzas, right? So in the first stanza the poet is telling no men are foreign, and sorry, no men are strange, no countries are foreign, and inside every uniform, no matter whatever we wear, the dress sense may be different, the ritual, the traditions, the culture, the language may be different, but from inside we all are one. What is telling? From inside, beneath a uniform, a single body lives, and whatever or in the same land we are going to reside, where are the people of the other country, they are also going to reside on the same earth. And beneath, like us, the land of our brothers walk upon, means like us, same, even the people of another country, they too walk on the same earth. They don't have some different earth, they too walk on the same earth. And once we die, or once the people of another country die, even they are going to bury inside the same earth. That is what we discussed in the first stanza. And in the second stanza, what the poet is telling, even the people of another country, the people of foreign, they too are aware of the same sun, water and air, means even they too need the same thing. The mother nature nourish everyone and treat everyone in the same way. Whether the nature is going to show any partiality between one country to another country? No, it treats all the people, all its children as the same, right? So even the people of another country, they too are aware of the sun, air and water, and fed by the peaceful harvest. Even nobody wants to war. Nobody wants to start a war, because they know if a war is going to take place, the cultivated land, the fertile land in which the human race is going to cultivate or grow crops to eat, it may get spoiled and the people may die starved. Starved means, very good, the people may die of hunger, of suffering the hunger. It's only happening when the people are going to start a war. So it means all the people, nobody wants to start a war, and their hands are own, and their lines we read, a labor not different from our own, means even they have the same hands. Even they to write the novels, they to write the rhymes, they to write the stories which we read. For example, if being an Indian, if you are going to write a story, your story is not only limited to the people of our country, it may publish to some other country. Even they may read, they may get a message what you want to tell them, right? So what it has been said, their hands are ours, and in their lines we read, a labor not different from our own, means how our countrymen, how the people of our country are going to work very hard to get successful. Like the same way the people, labor in the sense, the workers, the employees, they too work very hard. So here there is a James Kirkup, he is showing the similarity. He is going to show us the similarity of the humans. Okay, so this is what we discussed in the first two stanzas. So in today's class, we will discuss the remaining third and fourth stanza, what message he wants to give us by the help of the third and the fourth stanzas. My dear students, please open page number 58. Okay, see, remember, they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep, and strength that can be worn by love. In every land is common life that all can recognize and understand. Let us remember, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, it is ourselves that we shall dispose, betray, condemn. Remember, we who take arms against each other, it is the human earth that we defile. Our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air that is everywhere our own. Remember, no men are foreign and no countries strange. Okay, see, remember, they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep. Remember means, here the poet is telling, keep in the mind. Keep in mind, what we have to keep in mind? Remember, they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep. Again, there is a similarity in the outer appearance of the humans. Whether you think, sir, the people or the Americans, they have 3 or 4 eyes, 2 or 3 hands, 4 to 5 legs, no, right? So here there is a similarity. How he is telling that, James Kirkup? Remember, keep in the mind, they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep. Even they, the fellow people or the people of another country, they too have the same eyes. Means 2 eyes. They too have the eyes like ours, just like our. They too have the same eyes which wake or sleep. Means when they are going to sleep, they too will close the eyes. When they are going to wake, they are going to open the eyes. Remember, they have eyes like ours that wake or sleep, and strength that can be won by love. Very beautiful statement. Strength that can be won by love. Means in this world, anything can be won by the love. By just showing some mercy, by showing the sympathy, by showing the empathy to the others, by helping others, by giving the helping hands to others, even you can win the strongest battle. Just because you have the nuclear bombs, you have tanks, you have rifles, you have guns, you have modern machineries, modern weapons, you cannot win. Only strength can be won only by the love. If you are going to show love, even the strongest person, even the cruel person will get what? Love. He will love you. If you show love, if you show gratitude to someone, even the strongest person, even the cruelest person, he will surrender to you. Surrender means he will leave his badness, he will leave his negative things. So that is the intention of this statement. And strength that can be won by love means anything can be won by the love. Just because you have money, just because you are very superior, just because you have a dynamic personality, just because you are having a giant personality, you are physically, you are strong, you cannot win, my dear students. Strength can be won only by the love. Love is a universal language, right? Whether you agree or not. Universal language. Even the small baby can use this language. Even the old, aged human can use this language. So strength can only be won by the love. So, and strength that can be won by love in every land is common life that all can recognize and understand. Despite of what? Despite of various languages, despite of various cultures, despite of various traditions, rituals, languages, dressing sense, despite of huge population between one country to another country, there is one common life. There is one common life. What is that common life means? Each and every human being wants to live in a peaceful manner. That is common life. Nobody wants to spread hatism. Nobody wants to show hearted. Nobody wants to show what? Angriness. Everybody wants to live in a peaceful manner. So that is what it means. In every land is common life that all can recognize and understand. We have to recognize and we have to understand everybody in each and every country, there is a common life. In each and every country, there is a common life. Common life means each and everybody wants to live in a peaceful, in a harmony, even though there are lots of differences, there may be physical differences, there may be the difference in the languages and many other things, cultures, but there is a one common life we have to understand and we have to recognize. Recognize means we have to identify it, means we have to understand and respect the feelings of the others. We have to respect, we have to show the gratitude, we have to show the helping hand to the people of the another country, because we have to treat them as our brothers. We should not tell them, you do not belong to our country, you are not our countryman, so we won't accept you. No, my dear students, we have to greet them, we have to respect their feelings, we have to respect their words, we have to heed to their words. That is the intention of the third stanza. In every land is a common life that all can recognize and understand. As I said, love is a universal language, my dear students. As I told, strength can be won only by love. It is a universal language. Love is a language which doesn't matter about age, which doesn't matter about the religion, which doesn't matter about the nationality. No matter whoever you may be, if you are going to show love, you can win anything. Okay, so let us go for the last stanza. Let us remember, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, it is ourselves that we shall dispose, betray and condemn. Again, the James Kirkup, the poet of one of the beautiful poems, No Men Are Foreign, what he is telling? Let us remember means keep in the mind. Keep in mind what? Whenever we are told to hate our brothers, see, there are some of the people, some of the military organizations which may come to you and they will provoke you to start a war against another country, or they will tell you this kind of a people of this religion, they are harming our religion, they are harming our country, so we have to fight against them. Means they are provoking you, they are igniting you the negative thoughts in your mind. So whenever we are told, here we in the sense the people of a country, so whenever we are told to hate our brothers, here our brothers means the people of another country. Okay, so whenever someone is going to tell us to hate, just because he is from another country, we should not love him, we should not show respect to him, we have to fight with him, we have to abuse him. If someone is going to tell you that, what is going to happen? We are told to hate our brothers, it is ourselves that we shall dispose, betray and condemn. It means, if someone is going to tell you such kind of a things, if someone is going to put you some negative thoughts in your mind, instead of listening to them, what we have to do? We should not listen to them. It is what is it? It is ourselves, means we have to dispose them. If someone is going to tell you, hate them, don't love them, don't show the respect, don't listen to their words because they are not our countrymen. If someone is going to tell that, instead of listening to them, what we have to do? It is we that we shall dispose us. What is the meaning of dispose us? Banish, or we have to leave. If one of your friend is telling something, he bet you, right? So tomorrow you go and bet him. If such kind of a things is going to tell by your friend, what you have to do? You have to dispose him. Dispose means banish, or you have to leave him. Such kind of a friends are not good for you. Who are, instead of giving a good thoughts, if you are, instead of giving some of the positive thinking, they are filling you hateism. They are what? Making you to hate the another person. So what we have to do? We have to dispose, we have to banish, or we have to leave. That we shall dispose us, betray. What is the meaning of betray? To be disloyal, means don't show loyalty to such kind of a person who feel negativity in your mind. Don't show faith. Faithless means don't be loyal or don't show faith to such kind of a person. Condemn. What is the meaning of condemn? Dislike something. What you have to dislike? Means the acts. For example, if I told you there are some of the organizations or there are some of the people who may come to you and they may tell some things which provokes you to start a war or which provokes you to hate someone. So what you have to do, instead of listening to them, you have to leave such kind of a person. You have to disloyal. You don't show loyalty. You don't be faithful to such persons. Instead of you condemn them, means you dislike what they are going to do. That we shall dispose, that we shall dispose, betray or condemn. Remember, we who take arms against each other, it is the human earth we defile. So here, remember, again he is telling, again and again he is telling, remember, keep in mind, we who take arms against each other, what is the meaning of arms? Weapons. Okay, we who take arms against each other, it is the human earth we defile. He is telling, okay, even though in the first two lines, what he is telling, if someone is going to provoke you to do some of the negative things, don't listen to them. But although if your mind is weaker, even though if you start a war, if you take arms to kill your brothers or to start a war, actually what you are doing, even though by rejecting all the things, we who take the arms against each other, means brothers, against our brothers, if we use the weapons against each other, what is the effect? It is the human earth that we defile. We are not killing each other, but instead what we are doing, it is the human earth we defile. What is the meaning of defile? Spoil. We are spoiling the mother nature. Means when you are going to use the modern weapons, when you are going to throw the bombs, the fertile land from which we are going to get food, we are spoiling it. We are making it impure. We are not killing our brothers. Instead of that, we are making our mother nature impure. We are spoiling it. And we are killing our own race. Have you seen lion killing a lion? Elephant killing an elephant? Dog killing a dog? Cat killing a cat? No, because they know they are the same species. But we human beings, the people of another country, they do belong to the human race. But instead of that, we are killing each other. We are killing each other. Right? So, even though if we do like this, we are not only killing our brothers, but also we are spoiling, defiling the human earth. Our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air that is everywhere our own. See, our hells of fire. Hells of fire means evil effects of war. What is the meaning of hells of fire? The evil effects of war. Here, the James Kirkup is comparing, he is showing the similarity, or he is comparing the war to the hell. Because in a hell, our grandparents may tell us, in a hell, there is a fire, there is a dust, there is a fire. Like the same way, if a war is going to take place, that scenario is equal to hell. The situation is equal to hell. That scene is equal to hell. So our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence. Means even though if a human being is going to start a war, that scenario is equal to the hell. Okay. So our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence. Outrage means cruel act. Here, the war, it is a very cruel act, right? What is the meaning of outrage? The cruel act. Here, the war is a very cruel act. Cruel means which harms the human being or which harms anything. Here, what we are doing? We are outraging. We are harming the innocence. Here, innocence means what? Innocent people. What is the meaning of innocence here? Innocence means innocent people. Nobody wants to start a war. Even though if we start a war, we are killing the innocent people. The people who don't know anything, who are least bothered about such things, we are outraging. By the cruel act, we are harming, we are killing the innocent, means the innocent people. And of air that is everywhere our own. We are not only spoiling the earth, but also we are spoiling the air. we won't get the fresh air to breathe. When you are going to start a war, when you are going to put the bombs, nuclear weapons, atomic bombs, each and everywhere there will be dust. The pure air from which we are going to live, which helps us to live, we won't pay anything for that. By such acts, by such cruel acts, we will make it impure. The air is our own. We should not, it is not that we are paying the tax for them. It is a free, which is gifted from the Almighty God, which is gifted from the Mother Nature. But if we do, or if we start a war, we will impure it. We will spoil it. It is our own property. We have to look after that. For example, if you buy a car or a bike, you have paid it. How beautifully, how neatly you will keep it. Like the same way, the air, it is our own property, which is given by our ancestors. The earth, the beautiful earth on which we are living, our ancestors have given the gift. If we are going to spoil it by the war, for the next generation, we can't give it. Like our ancestors, our forefathers have gifted to us. If you are not going to keep that gift, we are not going to maintain the precious gift, we may not give it for our generations. So, if we are going to start a war, we are not only killing our own human race, but also we spoil the Mother Earth, we spoil the earth, we spoil the air, which is our own. So, remember, no men are foreign and no country is strange. Again, he is telling, remember, my dear students, remember, my dear readers, no men are foreign, no countries are strange. None in the entire globe, no men are foreign. All they are our brothers. Despite of lot of differences, they are like our brothers. Different, there is a lot of geographical difference from one country to another country. All the countries are same. All the countries are same. So never hate any person. Just love them, as I told, because strength can be only won by the help of love. So by telling this, we'll conclude the poem here. So if you got any doubts, my dear students, in the interaction class, we'll discuss it. Thank you.